critically, would also include a significant section of the user community, so people who want those databases and those services. And that's really, really important. So I'm just going to mention briefly how we sort of went about the process of discussing this. And not surprisingly, as you sort of expect for a digital group, we started off completely digitally. Everything that we did is in Google Docs. It's actually in a folder. If you follow that short little Google link there, I've opened it up to everyone. So anyone with that link can go in and see precisely what we did. So we started off by kind of like casting our net very wide by coming up with a big matrix of topics that we as informaticians are interested in. So issues to do with the kinds of data that we have to deal with, the kind of information products, the kind of services, the kind of tools that we build, but also, to some extent, some of the policies and process that we also have to deal with as part of the construction of these systems. So we ended up with quite a long list, about 38 things in that list. But of course, we've got to start boiling this down to what we call at this point the big integrating themes. And that's fundamentally the technical systems, the platforms that we typically build, the science challenges associated with new and emerging technologies, and also, very specifically, because it's highly relevant to us as natural history collections holders, the digitization challenges and the opportunities that by digitizing we can begin to unlock. So those were our three big integrating themes. But of course, really today, or really this meeting, in my view, is actually not so much about trying to come up with big lists. We discuss these lists kind of endlessly anyway. What we wanted was one big idea, one big theme, preferably one marketable theme, one concept that we could actually put forward to the European Union as a proposal. So what is our big idea? So, the big idea was basically what we characterized or called the top 1,000 species, a data integration and service infrastructure, identifying the top 1,000, or indeed whatever number you actually need, species relevant to science and society across a whole range of themes and issues. So things like European invasive species, threatened species, pest species, European crops, pollinator species. There are a myriad of these different lists, in effect, that are actually highly important and have very applied uses to particular communities, both nationally, because we have our national priorities, and also internationally and at a European level. So we need mechanisms to come up with these lists, and we need mechanisms by which our data can contribute ultimately the construction of those lists. Many of our institutions have quite large databases. We're all serving our specimen data. Many of us hold more niche data sets that are highly relevant to these species. There are also many big data aggregators out there which hold lots of information relevant to But what we don't have, what we're missing, are these integration layers that work across these different themes. So themes like spatial distributions and taxa, the phenotypic traits and taxa, temporal information about the occurrence of this, xenotypic data, the abiotic and remote sensing data. We don't have those integration layers that can work to bring all this information together. And of course, that would be an enormously ambitious task if we're trying to do it with everything, all life on Earth. But what we can do is target our activities, focus on these specific lists, these particular topics which are highly relevant. So the idea then is we're trying to build a system that builds these different aggregated and linked data layers, and also a community and curation platform that works not only just for scientists, but also for citizen scientists that can engage with this data and ultimately curate it. Now, of course, there's another element that we need to this. We need services on top of these data that people can not only access that, but visualize that, summarize that, and ultimately actually go back and enrich the source data. And we need to build that ecosystem of services too. So I think this is actually quite a big, potentially quite a fundable idea. So this would be this is a list of the objectives that we came up with from such a study. So the first one is just simply the act of gathering and providing crucial information about European priority species. But many groups need to know things like distribution of these taxa, their adaptive capacity, their ecology, how they impact on ecosystem services, both in a positive way and a negative way. Things like pest species and invasives, for example, are very negative impacts. We also need to identify what are the gaps in our ability to provide this information as institutions. And indeed, we can even go so far as to perhaps develop a cost calculator so that we can work out how much it would cost us as natural history providing institutions to fill those gaps. Obviously, as part of this project, we need to build that persistent technical infrastructure that's sustainable for managing and curating these data. And there are many examples of systems out there that are actually well suited to this. So, for example, we talked a little bit about Wikidata and the Wiki platforms as a mechanism to bring about that curation environment, that community curation environment. We'd also need to build this ecosystem of services across these data, driven by some very specific questions, so providing access to that content, visualizing that content, series of tools across these data, things like data quality indicators, and there will also be potentially ways of building services, things like computer vision tools or automatic trait extraction, such that you can actually begin to populate those data layers in a more automated way. One thought that also came up, and actually is highly relevant to the discussion that you just heard before, is providing, using this to provide a physical access gateway to our collection as well, at least for these priority species, so that one, through this portal, could identify what institutions have what collections relative to these important taxa, and potentially even apply across those institutions to gain physical access to the collections. Having led many big European collaborations before, I know the European community love big physical books, and so one product of this would be a big collaboratively created published research assessment for each of these top species that we could publish in some way, probably in a fairly boring and conventional way on paper. So the long-term goal will then be to dynamically, so at the moment these species lists will basically be artificial constructs. You'd have to consult the various groups that are responsible for identifying these priority taxa and manually construct those lists. But the long-term goal, and perhaps the most exciting one for me, is that one could imagine how one would dynamically construct those in the longer term. So this becomes almost a computational platform by which we can identify those priority taxa. And then finally, last but by no means least, in effect, through this system, we have a sustainable system of shared ownership for the data, for the technical platform, and also the division of labour across our different institutions. So those are the kind of top eight objectives. So what are the outcomes of this? Well, we have a sustainable technical platform and that set of technical services across these data. We have the assessments as well for those top X number of species across those different groups, which we could slice and dice in a myriad of different ways, not only for looking at European priorities, but our national priorities as well. We could potentially have a predictive tool from this data set that will perhaps begin to forecast and anticipate changes in these species lists. That's what I mean by having this dynamic production of these lists in the long term. And we'd also, through this mechanism, be able to organise, distribute, coordinate our efforts in terms of expertise, both at the citizen science level and at the professional level. So there are many impacts, I think, that one could imagine for this. We didn't get into this in too much detail, but those impacts span really most